Is your art boring? Does it lack that special sauce that helps it stand out from the crowd? Well, today I'm going to share with you my personal process for spicing things up and getting the most out of each image. So let's start with a classic example. Say you're drawing some kind of fantasy landscape, but it lacks that special sauce. You've got snow-capped mountains. You have a path winding towards the viewer. You've got rocks in the foreground to balance the composition, but it's just not taking off yet. Isn't it obvious? You're missing the man holding the stick. What about this painting you've made of an elven ranger? She's an elf. She has pointy ears. She's got a hood. Her eyes are glowing. She's looking sassily at the camera, but something's wrong. I mean, sure, she is drawing back an arrow in her bow and aiming it slightly to the left, and she's standing in a pretty badass pose, but hang on, why can't I see her ass and her breasts at the same time? Shouldn't she be contorting herself like a circus performer? Also, she must be a pretty boring ranger because she's only shooting one green glowing arrow from her bow. Shouldn't she have at least two or three? And if you haven't guessed it by now, I am joking. I'm having you on. These are things that I consider to be terrible tropes to fall into. We've all done stuff like this. Maybe not the contortionist stuff, but that image has been on Facebook and ArtStation several thousand times. But I'm certainly guilty of wandering stick salesman from time to time. It just serves like a good focal point and it helps to sell the scale and stuff, and it's just really easy and boring and boring, and it's just something the concept artists do to sell scale to people who are developing video games. It's not something that should actually be considered an interesting element in a piece of personal work. Don't do it, guys. Be a little bit more original. There are plenty of ways to sell scale. Well, it is pretty good sometimes, actually. But I'm trying to make a point here. It's not really these specific tropes that I'm saying avoid. The thing that really bugs me about the commercial entertainment art industry these days is it's just a soulless cash grab. They focus so much on cool factor. The designs are so cool. Everything is over the top. Characters embody not personality and interest. They just kind of represent a mannequin with which to equip different cool looking armor and weapons and stuff so that players can live out their video game power fantasies. But as far as having any real emotional impact, it's just not happening. But I don't want to be all poo-poo here. I respect the artists who work in the entertainment industry enormously. They're incredibly skilled craftsmen and craftswomen, and the work that they produce really does help to entertain and inspire so many people, so I don't want to talk down too much, but they're getting paid by big companies to make that art. And I'm pretty sure that if you were to ask them what they actually wanted to draw, a lot of the time it would probably be something a little more meaningful and personal, but they're just not getting paid to do that. And often if you dig around in some of these really incredible artists' portfolios, you'll find some little pieces of personal work hidden amongst all of that over-rendered Assassin's Creed concept art. And generally it's far more interesting. And by the way, that's probably the work that's getting them hired for these big jobs anyway. But anyway, the point is, if you have the time, why waste it making artwork that looks like it would fit into a video game concept art portfolio? If you have the time to make personal work, why not use it to make personal work? It's strange, you have all of these industry professionals who draw that kind of stuff all day, every day, and all they want to do is make something for themselves, something beautiful that's meaningful to themselves. And then you have millions of these artists beneath, trying desperately to get into that exclusive professional club, and all they're doing is trying to copy the professional work that these people are making, kind of missing the point that that's probably not even what the developers are looking for. They're probably looking for people who are doing their own thing that is interesting and fresh and new. They're like a vacuum cleaner for ideas. They want to suck it all up. If you're doing something good that they've never seen before, they're going to want you. And if you're just doing a pale imitation of what they're already doing, sure, maybe they'll take you on as an intern and pay you next to nothing to just render out assault rifles for the next 6 months. But is that really what you want? Maybe. Maybe. We're all going to take our own path, and there's nothing wrong with trying to get your foot in the door and work your way up. But, you know, I have learned over time that it's just not for me. I'm a hopeless purist and artsy swanklord hipster. I need my artwork to mean something to me, otherwise it's not satisfying to make. I worked for clients for some time and I'm just not cut out for it. I don't like being told what to draw. Because you just don't get asked to draw the kind of things that I want to draw. So if you look at the painting that's coming together in front of you right now, I want you to imagine this. You're sitting at work, you've been there all day. Your brain is so tired, you have deadlines, but you have to keep working even though it's like walking through molasses. You're trying to focus, you're trying to keep your head in the game, but the chair you're sitting in is just so uncomfortable, you need to stretch every 3 or 4 seconds and then you forget what you were doing and oh my god, is it nearly time to go home? Did you get any of that in the image? Is that the kind of feeling that you're getting conveyed? How close did I get? Because that's what I was going for. And even if I completely missed the mark for you, or you are unfamiliar with this feeling, I much prefer the kind of challenge that this illustration here presents to me rather than design some cool shoulder pads and a mad hat with a cool feather. And you know what? I like looking at that art too. It's always so much more satisfying. So I'm going to use my tiny little soapbox here to spruik to the world. Please make more interesting art. Look inside yourself and find things that you want to convey. And it doesn't have to be the standard stereotype of a tormented artist. It's all about pain. That's not what it's about. It's just about trying to explain what it is to be alive in a way that isn't simply talking about it. If you can present someone with an image that has them immediately go, "I have felt like that," or "I understand what you're saying," that is so goddamn satisfying. And if you work in this way, sometimes people will read into your work in ways that you had not imagined. And you realize that the stuff that you have created, the imagery that you've presented to people, has started to mean something different to them. They've taken it on board and it means something to them. You don't get that with these designs. If you only focus on cool, it can be so damn cool. It could wear 2 pairs of sunglasses and pull it off. But the fact is, most people just aren't that cool. Most people can't relate to that. Most people want to relate to that, and that's why video games are so successful. But the level of cool that comes from connecting with everyday people about shared experiences is so much cooler than any number of robots with toaster-shaped heads shooting laser guns at giant lizards. Hang on, that's pretty fucking cool. But there's an underserved community of people who appreciate meaningful art. And you owe it to yourself to give it a try because it can be satisfying in a way that toaster head robots just can't be. And with that, I'd like to thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please like, comment, and subscribe. And if you thought it was really good, why not share it with your friends and tell them to subscribe too. And I'll see you all next time.